okay, got the mark lesser than this. This is how the value over here is always read, okay? So therefore, the passing mark will be 42. 42, 43, 10 or so. But definitely not 42.5. Any questions? Okay, next we look at example 9. We have a cumulative frequency curve that represents the daily travel expenses of 800 students in two primary schools, A and B. Okay, so in A part 1, we want to find out what is the median from school A and school B, and then part B, we want to find the interquartile range. Okay, would you do part A and B now? Find the medians and also the IQR. Answer for median A. Sorry, 42. Any units? Okay, 42 cents. Median B. What's your answer? Let's see. 50. $0.28. Okay. And then what about the interquartile range, Songzhe? This one 25. How do you get 25? Sorry? 56 minus 32. 31.
Can I put
25 cents. Let's do a check. Okay, cause mine is 26. IQRA. So, first one, it should be 56, yes. Then after the lower quartile, you see it as 31. Okay, you can put it as 31 or 30. Also okay. Alright, part 2, the interquartile range. Alright, Hanjie, what would your interquartile range be? The interquartile range for B. What is your answer? I haven't done yet, okay, never mind. Zikai, 24. How do you get 24? 72 for minus 48, so 24 cents. Any other alternatives? 25, is it? Okay, 10. So 72 minus 47, 25 cents. Okay, so now the important question is to look at part C for this example. Alright, which school's pupils spend more on daily traveling expenses? Explain your answer. So we need to support our answer based on our values over here, our median and the interquartile range. Okay, so in general, if they are asking, okay, in general, right, in fact, in this case, okay, part C, they're asking in general whether the pupils spend more on daily traveling expenses or not, okay. If you're talking about general cases, right, we will compare the median, okay. So later on, I'll tell you when is it that we compare interquartile range, right. So in part C, if I want to compare the median, okay, we find that 58 cents is higher than 42 cents, so therefore, school B will actually be spending more on daily traveling expenses because of the higher median. So in phrasing your answer, the answer is school B, okay, because its median is higher. Okay, please don't end your sentence like that. It's higher. Higher than what? Always draw a comparison. Okay, it's higher than the median of school A. Alright, so always tell me higher than what? Okay. Why we're looking at median, it is because median is a measure of averages. Okay, it is a measure of averages. There are three different ways of measuring average: median, mean, and mode. Okay, so in this case, for cumulative frequency data, or rather the information here, we can only be looking at median. We will not be able to find the mean because we do not know what is the exact data value. Right, so relying on the median, which is a measure of average, okay, we will then be able to tell on average or in general, okay, which school is spending, which school has students spending more on traveling, okay. So in contrast, right, if you were to look at your practice now 5 on page 87, let me just flash this on the whiteboard. Okay, looking at this question itself, the question is rather similar. Part A and B is similar, right? Part C. Okay, let me just zoom in. Okay, part C says that stick with a reason if school A or school B perform better overall, versus the question part D, which is asking in which school were the twist marks more consistent. Okay, so part C was looking at overall. Okay, which also means that we're looking in general on average, okay, how does it perform? Okay, so in this case, part C, we will actually be using the idea of median to support our answer. Okay, whereas part D itself, we're looking at consistency. Okay, if you recall earlier on in the when I was talking about this, interquartile range is defined to be the measure of spread. Okay, so how spread out the marks are. So it's actually referring to the middle 50%, how spread out is it? So if the value for interquartile range is small, that means that the marks itself in this case, okay, it is actually rather consistent. Most of the students are getting similar score. That's why the interquartile range isn't that wide, okay, for the middle 50%. There isn't much use to actually be talking about the range, because there could be one very good student that can get 100 marks and then one very poor student that can get 2 marks. But it doesn't tell us the general performance, okay, of the other people in the class. So that's why we choose to talk about interquartile range. You understand what I'm saying? Okay, so therefore when we talk about consistency, we will be using interquartile range, which is a measure of spread, to do the discussion. Okay? So, Okay, so let me just write down the answer for practice now 5. So for practice now 5, the median will be 62 marks. And then after that, A part 2 is looking for interquartile range. Familiar with how to find median and interquartile range, I'll skip the hassle of doing this already. Okay, because our concern will be part C and D. Okay, so for part C as mentioned, we're looking at the performance overall. So we will actually be comparing the median. Okay, so we find that median for school A is 62 and median for school B is 70. So we're looking at who has a better performance. Of course, in this case, the higher the value, the better. Okay, so school B performed better. And the reason is because the median is higher. This median is higher than that of for part D, which school were the marks more consistent? Okay, so comparing the interquartile range, school A has a smaller interquartile range than school B. So with a smaller interquartile range, it means that the spread isn't that wide. Okay, so therefore the marks, okay, for the students in school A is more consistent, right, for the middle 50% of people. So in school A, interquartile range is smaller than that. Okay, you just have to explain by saying that the interquartile range is smaller, okay, or bigger based on the situation. You don't need to go about telling me what interquartile range means. You don't need to say, oh, because interquartile range is a measure of spread and then blah blah blah. No need. Okay? It will be understood, okay, why is it that we're looking at interquartile range. Right? Why is it that I'm pointing this out? Because it's very common that I see a lot of students talk about interquartile range, then give me one long grandmother story telling me about what interquartile range is. This will just be one mark, okay, and most 2 marks like that only. Okay? So it's very straightforward. Okay. Any questions? So, So exercise 3B. Question 1D, E, 3, 4, 7, 9. Same to get, okay?
Friday.
Thursday, can? Or Friday?
Friday.
Okay. In lieu of the fact that you're going for volleyball, although you're not playing, you're just supporting.
But then during the parents.
Okay, Friday, can? Alright, so tomorrow we will. Tomorrow we will continue box and whisper plots. And then maybe we might finish it.